The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, most high and most near, you send glad tidings to the lowly. You hide not your face from the poor. Those who dwell in darkness, you call into the light. Take away our blindness. Remove the hardness of our hearts. And form us into a humble people, that at the advent of your Son, we may recognize him in our midst and find joy in his saving presence. We ask this through him whose coming is certain, whose day draws near, your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Special welcome to all those worshiping with us by our Facebook page. Let us pray. Blessed are you, Sovereign Lord, just and true. To you be praise and glory forever. Your prophet John the Baptist was witness to the truth as a burning and shining light. May we, your servants, rejoice in his light, and so be led to witness to him who is the Lord of our common kingdom, Jesus, our Savior and King of the ages. Blessed be God forever. God our Father, you gave to Zechariah and Elizabeth in their old age a son called John. He grew up strong in spirit, prepared the people for the coming of the Lord, and baptized them in the Jordan to wash away their sins. Help us, who have been baptized into Christ, to be ready to welcome him into our hearts and to grow strong in faith by the power of the Spirit. We ask this through Jesus Christ, the light who is coming into the world. Amen. Lord Jesus, light of the world,
John told the people to prepare. But you were very near. As Christmas grows closer day by day, help us to be ready to welcome you now. Amen.
I invite Stephanie to come forward to light the third Advent candle. People of God, return. You are called to be God's own. From the mountains announce the good news. God comes in justice and peace to all who follow his ways. You are God's children.
Lord, make us one in the peace of Christ today and forever. Amen. Of your Holy Spirit, that we may pray.
Stir up your power, Lord, that with great might come among us. And because we are sorely hindered by our sins, let your bountiful grace and mercy speedily help and deliver us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the ministry of the Lord.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Isaiah, beginning at the first verse. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and to release the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities. The devastations of many generations, for I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as the garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And the Lord is for us.
reading from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 24. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit. Do not despise the words of prophets, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
according to John.
Glory to Christ, our Savior.
There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to the light, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. This is the testimony given by John when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who are you?" He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed, "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you a prophet?" He answered, "No." Then they said to him, "Who are you?" "Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord,' as the prophet Isaiah said." And they had been sent from the Pharisees. They asked him, "Why then are you baptizing, if you are neither Messiah, nor Elijah, nor the prophet?" John answered them, "I baptize with water. Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals." This took place in Bethany, across the Jordan, where John was baptizing. This is the Gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, our Lord.
Let us pray. Lord, take my lips and speak through them. Take our minds and think through them. Take our hearts and set them on fire with love for you. Amen. Please be seated. In her writings, The Gospel Without Compromise, Catherine de Huet Dougherty, a great woman of the 20th century, posits, and I quote, "Christians are called to become icons of Christ, to reflect him. But we are called to even more than that. We are called to incarnate Christ in our lives, to clothe our lives with him, so that people can see him in us, touch him in us, recognize him in us." End quote. While contemplating Catherine's words, a vivid memory from Wednesday, October 29th, flashed before my mind's eyes. As Desmond and I sat at the breakfast table, a phenomenal occurrence caused me to gasp in delight. The space around us was miraculously transformed by the most awesome beams of colored light. Breakfast forgotten, I gleefully hopped around as I counted 20 amazing groups of beams of light in our environment. My morning was made. Joy flowed through my being. I could, however, not help but ponder the reason for this occurrence. Truth dawned. The glass floor lamp, a precious gift, had been repositioned from its obscure corner in the living room to a place where the open blinds would allow the light from the sun to have total access to it. My brothers and sisters, if you and I believe that by virtue of our baptism, God has called us to be witnesses to the light, Jesus the Christ, then, like that floor lamp, that precious gift, you and I may have to undergo a season in which we are being shifted from our zone of comfort. Easier said than done, some may say. It is therefore no coincidence on this third Sunday of Advent, we, the body of Christ, are privy to vicariously experience through John's encounter with investigators sent by the Jews, a deeper understanding of the difficulty involved in being a witness to God's light. So, here we are in Bethany, the place where John is baptizing. Let us listen to a most enlightening interview of John, chosen by God to bear witness to
the light. The interview is being conducted by a delegation of respected Jewish priests and officials. I use the Voice translation. Who are you? I'm not the Anointed One, if that is what you are asking. Your words sound familiar, like a prophet's. Is that how we should address you? Are you the prophet Elijah? No, I am not Elijah. Are you the prophet Moses told us would come? No. Then tell us who you are and what you are about, because everyone is asking us, especially the Pharisees, and we must prepare an answer. Listen. I am a voice calling out in the wilderness. Straighten out the road for the Lord. He's on his way. End of this aspect of the interview. As guardians of the faith, it is the duty of the Pharisees to investigate any new preaching. John has quite a following. It keeps growing. So these representatives are charged with finding out what are John's credentials as a prophet and what is it that makes John popular. Sounds familiar? Brothers and sisters, neither the religious hierarchy nor their delegation's persistent questioning can phase God's enigmatic witness. In the face of their scrutiny, John remains resolute, unwavering. He has zero interest in making the interview about himself. Worthy of note is the fact that the more the group of priests and officials press John to declare his identity, is the more John focuses on his God-given role. John, a model for all who will follow Jesus, unequivocally points his examiners beyond himself to the one who is the true light. Perhaps we can imagine hearing John say to the reporters, "This is not about me. It's not even about what you think of me. It's about your becoming open to him who is pure light." So intent was this group on acquiring information about John's identity and John's credentials that they totally missed the more important subject matter. And what was that? John was not the light. He came to testify to the light, John 1:8. As the Message translation puts it, he was there to show the way to the light. Living today in what may be termed an egocentric time in our culture, one can indeed become caught up in the posturing and self-aggrandizement of witnesses who display the only I can do the job mentality. In doing so, one can completely miss the intended message of these witnesses. And so what a breath of fresh air it is for us to hear John's testimony as he responds to the questions posed by the delegation. I am not the Messiah. I am not Elijah. No, I am not the prophet. What I am is the voice of one crying in the wilderness, "Make straight the way of the Lord," as the prophet Isaiah said. I am nothing more, nothing less. On this Gaudete Sunday, the Sunday of joy, in this differently difficult season of 2020, permit me to ask a question. Is the body of Christ positioned to powerfully proclaim again and again, "We are not the light, but we are here to bear witness to the light"? My brothers and sisters in Christ, the church, through him who loves her, calls and empowers her, is in need of no material makeover. Like John, God, who calls her as she is, to point others to Jesus, reminds her that she is enough. It is God and God alone who will reposition her as seems best to him. We often hear some say, at this time of the year, the church's calendar is full. And others say the church is no longer relevant. Yet, with, in, and through every activity, and I will name a few: Advent contemplation, 9 lessons with carols, Christingle, baskets of love for her master's children, gifts, parties, time to allow the bereaved to mourn losses experienced this year. These are acts of worship. And through every act of worship, the church, like John, must be unwavering as she focuses on her peculiar, God-gifted role in the world. Icon of Christ, called to incarnate Christ in her life, to clothe her life with Christ, so that people can see Christ in her, touch Christ in her, recognize Christ in her. As church, I invite us to ask God in Jesus Christ to help us to embrace the words of the first verse of this hymn by David Haas. Come, live in the light. Shine with the joy and the love of the Lord. We are called to be light for the kingdom, to live in the freedom of the city of God. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another, to walk humbly with God. Brothers and sisters, may we fully yield to God's repositioning. I pray that as God moves us from our corners of comfort, we will point others to the light emanating from God's only Son as it flows unhindered in and through our being. Amen.
Let us now, with a sense of confidence, reaffirm our faith as we say in the words of the Nicene Creed, we believe in one God, the Father of the Trinity, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen or unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in the beginning with the Father. Through him all things were made.
God, the source of all light and life, send your Spirit upon the church for the declaration of the gospel to all nations. Give to your people the prophetic voice that brings knowledge of salvation through Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Restore to new life the places that human sin and folly have made desolate. Guide into the true light of repentance those who work wrath and destruction. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lead all nations to be one in the name of Christ. Make us your messengers among our friends and neighbors and all with whom we share our lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless to our rich harvest all the signs of hope and growth in our community. Bring freedom to those who are unjustly in captivity and those who are imprisoned in their own despair. Comfort and rise up to new life those whose hearts are broken by sorrow. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We give thanks to all who have heard the message of salvation and passed from this world into the full knowledge of Christ. Keep us constant in faith until we too shall come to him. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray confident in the grace of baptism and led by the light of Christ. Amen.
As we continue in this time of prayer, we remember all those who are celebrating during the course of this week, those celebrating birthdays or anniversaries. And I invite those persons who are present, who are celebrating, to come forward for their blessing as we uphold in prayer. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The acts of penance. We are reminded in Holy Scripture that if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Let us therefore confess our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not loved ourselves as we ought. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Peace out. We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body, and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit.
Let us then pursue the things that make for peace, and build up the common life.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Sister Annalise.
Okay, welcome to our service this morning. A special welcome to my sisters in the altar guild as we make our corporate communion. And welcome to all those as well watching us on Facebook. I don't think we have any first-time visitors this morning, so we will go right into the notices. And so we convey our deepest sympathies this morning to our sister Barbara Rankin on the death of her aunt in Jamaica. And also, our sympathies go out to our sister Elaine Thomas on the death of her brother Valentine in Jamaica. May the souls of the faithfully departed rest in peace.
We also remember in our prayers our Brother Rupert Vasquez and family on the death of his brother. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord, for let light perpetual shine. May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercies of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Amen. And so the Christmas, jazz Christmas concert being put on by the Cayman Arts Festival is taking place this coming Thursday at 7:30, at 6:30 p.m. right here at St. George's. Tickets are here, they are available at the back at the usher's desk, and they are a steal at only $10 each. So we are asking you and reminding all groups to submit their reports. This is now, we're a week away. They'll be due next Monday, the 21st. So please do get those into us. They're short this year, I'm sure. So I'm sure there'll be no issue getting them in on time. And also those persons who have not yet been able to give in their pledges, just a gentle reminder that as we're coming to the end of the year, if you could bring those in as well, that would be most appreciated. And so tonight, we are having our Festival of Nine Lessons and Carols at 6 p.m. All are invited. Please do come out, bring a friend or two. I know the choir and our instrumentalists have been practicing really hard, so we look forward to all that is in store. And our Midweek Holy Eucharist continues this and every Wednesday at 7:30 a.m. Anyone having difficulty attending one of our acts of worship, please contact the church office or Sister Andrea Gilbert, so let's see how we can coordinate that. And the Altar Guild reminds anyone who wishes to make a floral contribution for a special occasion in your life or that of a loved one to please reach out to Sister Marlene Ricketts at 925-9120. So our Advent calendar gift bag drive is on. I think next Sunday, the 20th, is the day for you to bring in your bags, your shopping bags full of items, to be distributed to the less fortunate in our community. Of the notices, I think our Blue Christmas service, that's going to take place next Sunday, the 20th of December at 7 p.m. I think also I noticed in the bulletin that for those of you who might not have known, there was an island off the coast of Nicaragua called Providencia that was completely destroyed by Hurricane Iota. And so it was actually a Cat 5 when it hit them. And so we are just taking up, you know, anything that you might be able to give. And if you are able to, we're asking you to bring that in next Sunday. And we'll arrange for that to get to those persons on that island. I think that is it. So I will see you all later this evening at the Festival of Nine Lessons and Carols.
Thank you. this wine and this money. With them we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work, to become, through your Holy Spirit, a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your will. Through the saving Christ, our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of eternal life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may, without shame or fear, rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy is your life. God, power and might. Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Eucharistic prayer be. Please sit or kneel. Holy and gracious Father, all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, whom you sent to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. We therefore bring you these gifts, and we ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who offered himself in obedience to your will, the perfect sacrifice for all humankind. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it, for the remembrance of me." Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. Father, call into mind the death your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension, his continual intercession for us in heaven, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering, and grant that we who eat and drink these holy gifts may be filled with your Holy Spirit and become one body in Christ, and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. May he make us a perpetual offering to you, and enable us in communion with Blessed Mary and the whole company of heaven to share in the inheritance of your saints. With him, and in him, and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power to you, Lord, forever and ever. Amen. As our
our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we have shared one bread.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Our souls will feast and be satisfied, and we will sing thy songs with praise to thee.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
Eternal God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you and all persons in you with gladness and singleness of heart, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you and scatter the darkness from before your path. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Safe and enjoyable day and week to everyone.
Let us listen to your seeking.